Okay, so this series of video will show you how to use a client mode so that we can eventually use multiple sensors on one computer. This time we're going to use an external router, and here is the MUGIC, so I'm going to turn it on. So with one hand. Now it's blinking fast, blinking slower, and then it will blink every second, which means that MUGIC is now in AP mode, which means it has a Wi-Fi network. So let's see, you go to your Wi-Fi here, and see, it shows, you know, my MUGIC connect. So this is this sensor that is just turned on, but I am still connected to the file hub plus. Then go to system preference. Okay, so now I have a Wi-Fi connected. This is File Hub Plus. And note, there is a IP address here. So 10.10.10.2 is my File Hub address. Okay, now the MUGIC is connected to the USB cable. And then go to, I will do it from the beginning. Open the MUGIC app. And you see at the left one, MUGIC, he says choose serial port, so I'm just going to use this USB right now. USB slab, this is my driver, which you should download from the website. It's in the musicmotion.com. And here you go. You can look at who this is, so you can press refresh, and it'll tell you who the sensor is and all the information. So I have a MUGIC connect, this is this sensor, and Wi-Fi server mode is 1. Okay, we're gonna change this to 0 and client mode to 1. Okay, so now go to config. And then you go to config client mode and enter here the name of your file hub, your router. So it's file hub plus 58AC. So file hub plus dash 58AC, like this. And then here, Wi-Fi client password, which is default, it's a okay. I think it's that, and then let's see, it's 8 ones. It's a default password, and then this one is 10.10.10.2, as it said in the system preference. And then I want to name this sensor a port, so let's say this is going to be 5001, and just to be different, and you submit all, and it says it's all set. Look, it's everyone's that, right? 5001 and 10.10.10.2, and here MUGIC state is not yet 10.10.2. because I haven't committed yet. So switch MUGIC to Wi-Fi client mode and commit changes to EEPROM. So I click that. And it's blinking a little fast, trying to find the file hub. And now look, it switched to Wi-Fi client 1. Right? So this is all set. Now, you can go to any Macs or whatever. I have this funny testing thing. So let's say, what was it, 5001? See, it's working. Okay, so now this guy is done. Okay, so this is my second sensor now. I just connected the USB as I did the first one. And make sure this is set to serial port, is set to your USB driver. And then let's just look at it. the sensor is called Maharishi Jiggly sensor, and I've already committed that. We just did. Okay, let's just do it again to just make sure. So file hub plus is 58EC. I have a thing, and this time I'm going to set the data port to 5002 because the first sensor was 5001. So everything the same. Set the router name and the password and the IP address of your router here in the system preference Wi-Fi, and then 5002 instead. Okay, I will submit all. I just click the submit all. It says all set. Then switch MUGIC to, oh, let's just check. So right now it's Wi-Fi server mode 1. Now switch client mode, and now it's looking for it. The blue light is blinking fast. Now it's slow. Look, now it's changed to Wi-Fi client 1. Okay, so let's go back to my max patch. And what was this again? The second sensor was 5002. So there, see? So this is my second sensor, and this is my first sensor, see? So I can move independently together, okay? All right.